Welcome to Biology at Ease. This video is part 7 of Biological Classification Lecture Series. Pichle video mein we discussed the division Bryophyta. Now in this video, I'll be covering the topic division Pteridophyta. Pteridophyta jo word hai, it is derived from two Greek words. Pteris, which means fern, and phyton, which means plant. So division Pteridophyta includes fern plants. Agar hum definition ki baat karein, to Pteridophyta includes seedless vascular plants. Yani ki it is a division of the plants jinme seeds absent hote hain and the vascular system called xylem and phloem are present. So Pteridophyta includes seedless vascular plants. Ab kyunki inme vascular system present hota hai, that is why this division is also known as vascular cryptogams. Cryptogams kyun? Kyunki ye subkingdom cryptogamy ke andar aata hai. Subkingdom cryptogamy ke teen divisions hote hain, Thallophyta, Bryophyta and Pteridophyta. And out of these three divisions, Pteridophyta ek aisa division hai jisme vascular system present hota hai. So that is why the division Pteridophyta is known as vascular cryptogams. Ab basic characteristics dekh lete hain, inki plant body kaisi hoti hai. Pteridophyta division ke andar jitne bhi plants aate hain, they have well differentiated plant body. Yani ki inki body true roots, leaves, stem, branches, in sub parts mein divided hoti hai. The main plant body is sporophyte. Yani ki inki jo main plant body hoti hai, usme two sets of chromosomes present hote hain. Last video mein humne padha tha ki bryophyte ki jo main plant body hoti hai, wo gametophytic hoti hai, yani ki having single set of chromosomes. Lekin Pteridophyta ki main plant body kaisi hoti hai? Sporophytic hoti hai, that is having two sets of chromosomes. So the main plant body of the Pteridophyta is sporophytic and it is well differentiated into various parts. Sex organs ki baat karte hain, jo reproductive organs hote hain, they are multicellular and jacketed, that is they are covered and made up of multiple number of cells. Leaves ki baat kare to jo Pteridophyta ke andar plants hote hain, inme two types ki leaves pai jati hain. Some plants have small leaves and these leaves are known as microphylls. Iska example ho jata hai Selaginella. Selaginella ek aisa Pteridophyte plant hai jiske paas small leaves hoti hain and these small leaves are known as microphylls. Whereas there are many other pteridophytes like ferns which contains large leaves and the large leaves are known as macrophylls. So two types of leaves are found in pteridophytes, small leaves which are known as microphylls and the large leaves which are called as macrophylls. Gametophyte. Hame pata hai ki bryophytes aur pteridophytes ke life cycle mein two types of plant bodies are involved, sporophyte and gametophyte. Bryophyte mein humne padha tha ki jo bryophyte plants hote hain, inki main plant body gametophytic hoti hai aur wo gametophytic plant body phir sporophyte banati hai. Sporophyte kya karti hai? Spores produce karti hai aur wahi spores wapas germinate hoke gametophyte banate hain and the cycle gets repeated. To bryophytes ke case mein kya hota hai? Jo gametophytic plant body hoti hai, wo dominant stage hoti hai plant ki. Lekin in pteridophytes, the main plant body is sporophytic, whereas the gametophytic plant body is short-lived. So what will we say? The dominant stage in the life cycle of the pteridophyte is sporophytic stage, whereas the gametophytic stage, wo wali stage jisme plant body single set of chromosome contain kar rahi hai, wo stage is short lived. To gametophytic stage mein kya hota hai? Jo plant body hoti hai uske paas sex organs present hote hain. Ye sex organs sex cells produce karte hain. Fusion between the sex cells forms zygote. Zygote embryo form karta hai. Embryo lately forms sporophyte. Aur sporophyte main plant body hoti hai, jo spores produce karti hai. And the spores again forms the gametophyte. And this is how the cycle gets repeated. Ab jo ye gametophyte plant body hoti hai, humne kaha ki isme sex organs present hote hai. Kuch plants aise hote hain jinke paas gametophytic plant body ke andar male and female reproductive structures, that is both the reproductive structures are present. Such gametophytic plant body is known as monoecious. To monoecious kya ho gaya? Monoecious refers to the gametophyte in which both male and female reproductive structures or male or female reproductive organs are present. Whereas dioecious is a term जिसे हम use करते हैं उस gametophytic plant body के लिए जिसमें या तो सिर्फ male reproductive organ present होगा या फिर सिर्फ female reproductive organ present होगा. So gametophytes, that is the plant body of the bryophyte containing the reproductive organs, are of two types: monoecious, in which both male and female reproductive structures are present, or it can be dioecious, jispe either the male reproductive organ is present or the female reproductive organ is present. Habitat ki baat kare to pteridophytes aapke cool, damp, shady places mein paaye jaate hain. Thandi jagah jahan chhaya ho, aisi jagah pe aapke pteridophytes paaye jaate hain, and they require water for the process of fertilization. इतनी सारी requirements होने की वजह से pteridophytes की जो population है वो बहुत restricted area में पाई जाती है. जहाँ पे इनको favorable condition मिलेगी वो वहीं पे grow करेंगे. अगर इनमें से एक भी condition missing है तो इनकी growth होना difficult हो जाता है. So because of the high requirements for the process of growing, the pteridophytes are restricted to limited areas. Life cycle की बात करते हैं. हमने कहा जो main plant body होती है वो कैसी होती है? Having two sets of chromosomes, that is the main plant body is known as sporophyte. क्या होता है जब plant अपनी sporophyte condition में present है, यानि कि उसकी body well differentiated है, leaves, roots, stem, branches, इन सब parts में, तो जो leaves होती हैं pteridophytes की, ये leaves कुछ-कुछ leaflets ऐसी होती है, यानि कि leaves के कुछ-कुछ part ऐसे होते हैं जिनमें structures present होते हैं containing the spores. So some leaflets present on the leaves of the pteridophytes contain structures having spores, and these structures are known as sporangia. Sporangia kya hota hai? Sporangia aise structure hote hain jo ki pteridophytes ke kuch kuch leaves mein present hote hain, aur in sporangia ke andar spores present hote hain, aur ye spores germinate hoke aapke gametophyte banate hain. So the leaves of some pteridophytes contain sporangia, aur wo leaves ya fir wo leaflets jo ki sporangia contain karte hain unhe kehte hain sporophyll. तो ये आपके स्पोरोफिल हो गए जिसमें आपके स्पोरेंजिया प्रेजेंट हैं. तो सपोज ये आपकी लीव्स हैं pteridophyte plant की, कुछ leaves जिसमें sporangia present है, उन leaves को हम बोलते हैं sporophyll. अब क्या होता है, कुछ-कुछ cases में ये leaves containing the sporangia, that is the sporophylls, ये sporophylls आपका cone-like structure बनाते हैं, and this cone-like structure is known as strobili. तो strobili क्या होता है? Strobili is a cone-like structure formed by the sporophylls of pteridophyte plants. तो अब life cycle में क्या होता है? जो आपका sporophyte है, यानि कि जो आपकी main plant body है, उसके sporophylls, उसकी leaves contain करती है sporangia, and the sporangia contains spores. ये spores germinate होके क्या बनाते हैं? Gametophyte. Gametophyte को हम prothallus भी कहते हैं, and it contains single number of chromosomes. तो क्या हुआ? Sporophyte के sporophylls थे, यानि कि वो leaves थी जिनके पास sporangia present था. Sporangia ने spores produce करे, spores grow हुए और उन्होंने gametophyte बनाया. अब the gametophyte plant body contains male and female reproductive structures. ये male और female reproductive structures या फिर reproductive organs sex cells produce करते हैं, that is enthrozoites and egg. Fusion between enthrozoites and egg leads to the formation of zygote. तो क्या हुआ? Gametophyte के पास enthridium और archegonium थे, ये दो structures थे. इन structures ने sex cells produce करे, fertilization हुआ sex cells के बीच और क्या बना? Zygote बना. Zygote further develop होके क्या बनाता है? Embryo. And the embryo finally develops into sporophyte. And then again the cycle is repeated. And this is how the life cycle of pteridophyte is completed. So I hope you are clear with this concept. Let's quickly revise everything. Pteridophyta is a division of seedless vascular plants, and they are also known as vascular cryptogams. They have well differentiated plant body, that is their body is divided into roots, branches, stem and leaves. Some of the leaves of the pteridophyte plants contain a structure called sporangia in which spores are present, and such leaves are known as sporophylls. Sporophylls in some cases combine to together to form a cone-like structure, jise kehte hain strobili. The larger leaves of the pteridophyte plants are known as macrophylls, whereas the small leaves are known as microphylls. Jo main plant body hoti hai pteridophytes ki, wo sporophytic hoti hai, having two sets of chromosomes. Sporophytic body spores produce karti hai, spores germinate hoke aapke gametophyte banate hain. Gametophyte ke andar male and female reproductive structures hote hain, jo ki sexes banate hain. Sexes fuse hote hain, aapka zygote banate hain, which further forms embryo, leading to the formation of sporophyte. And again, the cycle is repeated to continue the generation of the pteridophytes. Examples dekh lete hain. The examples of division pteridophyta includes selaginella, ferns, equisetum and marsilia. Ye most common or easiest examples hain jo aap easily learn kar sakte hain. Economic importance ki baat karte hain. Jo aapke pteridophyta plants hote hain, wo economic ke liye bhi bahut important hote hain. Kaise? Pehla to, they helps in preventing soil erosion. Dusra, equisetum ek aisa pteridophyte plant hai which is used for polishing of the metals. Ye metals ko polish karne ke liye use kiya jata hai. Some of the pteridophyte plants like marsilia is used as food. So, kya kya importance ho gayi? Pteridophyte plants helps in preventing soil erosion. They are used as food. They also helps in polishing of metals and they are also used for medicinal purpose. Pteridophyte plants medicines banane mein bhi helpful hote hain. So, these are the economical importance of the pteridophytes. Ab bryophytes aur pteridophytes ko differentiate karte hain. Kya difference ho jayenge? Bryophytes ki main plant body is gametophytic. Whereas, the main plant body of pteridophyte is sporophytic. Bryophytes pe true roots are absent, rhizoids are present. Whereas in pteridophytes, true roots are present. Bryophytes are non-vascular, that is, they do not contain xylem and phloem, whereas the pteridophyta division contains vascular system, that is, they have xylem and phloem. Examples bhi differentiation mein include ho jayenge. Bryophytes includes rickettsia, marchantia, whereas pteridophytes includes selaginella and ferns. So this is all about the division pteridophyta. I hope you're clear with the content. If you like this video, do hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for the upcoming videos. Thank you so much for watching.